The Virginia-class nuclear-powered cruise missile fast attack submarine is the latest vessel in the United States Navy's arsenal. The design incorporates the latest in stealth, intelligence, and weapon systems technology to be applied for special deep-ocean anti-submarine warfare and littoral operations. A formidable weapons platform, the attack submarine can launch up to 16 Tomahawk cruise missiles in a single salvo, but the remarkable feat is not enough for the Navy. The Virginia-class vessels are set to become the first submarines in the world armed with high-energy laser weapons. However, a big hurdle is standing in the way. Lasers don't seem to work underwater. Still, the Navy continues to work on the model, and most of the system's capabilities are yet to be unveiled. But the expectations are that Virginia's laser weapon could radically change naval warfare forever. Change in pace. The USS Seawolf-class nuclear-powered fast-attack submarines were initially intended to provide a replacement for the Los Angeles-class, an aged series that saw action during the Cold War. However, by the time the first model was actually commissioned, strategic requirements had changed, budgets had shifted, and the Soviet Union had fallen. As such, the production of the most expensive U.S. Navy fast-attack submarine was canceled after only 3 models were produced. Years later, in 1991, the Navy began the development of the next generation of attack submarines. Developed under the codename Centurion, later renamed the Virginia-class, the model was intended to be a less expensive alternative to the Seawolf, with a $1 billion budget difference. In order to reduce costs, Virginia-class engineers used many commercial off-the-shelf components, and ongoing technology has trimmed production costs even further, below the $1.8 billion per submarine price tag. By 2007, more than 35 million labor hours had been spent on the Virginia-class construction. A modern-day submarine. The Virginia-class, also known as the SSN-774-class, is a type of nuclear-powered cruise missile fast-attack submarine in service with the United States Navy, going back to the early 2000s. The first American nuclear-powered cruise missile fast-attack submarine of the post-war era, she'll provide the U.S. Navy the capabilities required to maintain undersea supremacy well into the 21st century. As the service's newest undersea warfare platform, the Virginia-class submarine incorporates all the latest available technology, as well as unique warfare enhancements. With these improvements, the class is tailored to excel in a wide range of warfighting missions, including seeking and destroying enemy submarines and surface ships, projecting power ashore with Tomahawk cruise missiles and special operation forces, carrying out intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions, supporting battlegroup operations, and engaging in mine warfare. With a total length of 377 feet, displacing approximately 7,800 tons fully submerged, the submarine can sail at a top speed of 25 knots. Meanwhile, her crew consists of 15 officers and 117 enlisted men. The initial construction contract for the first 4 Virginia-class nuclear-powered attack submarines, Virginia, Texas, Hawaii, and North Carolina, was awarded to Electric Boat Corporation, with Newport News Shipbuilding serving as the primary subcontractor in September of 1998. As of 2022, 22 Virginia-class submarines have been completed, and a total of 36 have been procured through the fiscal year. A team of shipbuilders, industry suppliers, and the Navy consistently deliver them under budget and ahead of schedule. At the cutting edge. The Virginia-class has special features to support special operation forces, depending on the mission, and the traditional periscopes have been replaced by 2 photonics masts. First created in the 1990s, photonics masts have 360-degree rotating cameras that catch anything on the horizon with high-resolution black-and-white footage. The submarine's torpedo room can even be reconfigured to house a large number of special operations forces, complete with all their equipment for prolonged deployments. However, In addition to the submarine's advanced capability torpedoes and Tomahawk land attack cruise missiles, the Virginia class may soon add another technology to its already impressive features. According to open source budget documents, Virginia class submarines will be equipped with a high energy laser weapon. This was further confirmed by a United States Naval postgraduate school's lengthy study regarding the integration of a high-energy laser, or HEL, into the class. On the other hand, the Navy itself published a thesis summary, but officials withheld further details. Available information suggests that the HEL could be incredibly powerful, with a range of up to 500 kilowatts, powered by the submarine's nuclear reactor. It is even said that it may already have been tested using a towed power generator, and that the laser will most likely be incorporated into the photonics masts. On land and air, laser weapons strike at the speed of light, quickly deploying to every possible fighting domain. However, laser light scatters and absorbs quickly while underwater, much like sunlight. With a submarine reaching complete darkness past 3,280 feet, it would seemingly render laser weapons useless. Still, there are a few suggestions for applications for such laser technology. Tight-lipped. Without much available information, submarine experts outside the military have speculated why the Navy wants to fit a laser onto submarines. One of the possible uses for the novel laser technology is as a modern defense mechanism against aircraft such as drones and anti-submarine helicopters. While earlier submarines were equipped with machine guns as an on-the-surface defense, post-war ones spent little to no time above water. In fact, the United States Navy hasn't installed machine guns on submarines for over 70 years. The laser could also be intended for North Korean and Iranian speedboat swarms. While individual ones are not worth launching a torpedo for, their wildly unmatched speeds actually make a successful attack much harder. Finally, another option is to strike critical coastal targets like radar stations, communications masts, or submarine piers. With United States Navy officials refusing to speak to the press about the mysterious laser project, its exact function, and the types of targets it is projected to attack remain a mystery. And while it may be years before the full capabilities of the system are revealed, this laser could be what sets this submarine apart from all the other active ones in the world. Never-ending updates. The Virginia-class submarine design has been updated multiple times since 1998. All the innovations ensure that the ship will be affordable in enough numbers to satisfy America's future nuclear attack submarine force level requirements. As such, the Virginia-class construction blocks have continued to evolve since the first submarine was commissioned in 2004. Each successive block has incorporated additional capabilities and advanced technology while reducing costs. And just like the last Los Angeles-class attack submarines, the first two blocks of the Virginia-class have a vertical launch system in the bow, with space for 12 Tomahawk missiles. However, starting with Block 3, two key design changes were made, including replacing a traditional sonar sphere with a more modern large-aperture bow array, and the vertical system with two large payload tubes, each carrying 6 missiles. In addition, as part of the carrier's third or Block 3 contract, the Navy redesigned approximately 20% of the ship to reduce acquisition costs. This design change resulted in the reduction of the overall procurement costs by 30% without compromising any vital aspects, allowing for the construction of 2 Virginia-class attack submarines per year beginning in 2011. Moreover, the Virginia payload module was the next significant design change to the class, starting with Block 5. Also called the VPM, it is a new 84-foot section, inserted into the existing submarine design, that contains an additional 4 large-diameter payload tubes, like the ones added in Block 3. But unlike the bow payload tubes, the VPM ones can each carry 7 Tomahawk missiles, upping the total number to 28. The first VPM-equipped submarine began construction in 2019. these soon-to-be-introduced VPN-equipped submarines are the most cost-effective way to restore the Navy's undersea strike capacity, which will drop by 60% when the Ohio-class submarine force is retired by the decade's end. The future is bright. The promising technology in the United States program has not gone unnoticed by the international export market. In September of 2021, Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison announced the cancellation of a contract with a French shipbuilder to construct 12 attack-class diesel submarines based upon the French Navy's Barracuda-class nuclear sub. The same day, Australia, the United Kingdom, and the United States announced the AUKUS, or AUKUS, Trilateral Security Pact. With the agreement, the United States agreed to share nuclear propulsion technology with Australia and the UK. Under AUKUS, the Australian Navy is set to acquire at least 8 nuclear-powered submarines, with the overall design and key technologies decided by a research team with assistance from the other two nations. It is rumored that Australian officials may select the Virginia design or use most of its nuclear propulsion technology in a new design. Back in the United States, the Virginia-class submarines will be acquired through 2043 and are expected to remain in service until at least 2070. As the threats to national security in the seven oceans continue to evolve, the submarine industrial base design will continue to change, and it will all be achieved through extensive modular construction, open architecture, and commercial off-the-shelf components. Such submarines might be the right vehicles for the United States Navy's most critical underwater missions, complete with a strange and mysterious laser beam, well into the 21st century. Thank you for watching Dark Seas. Before you go, make sure to hit the like button and share our video with someone who might like it. And for more stories of naval warfare, as well as exciting military anecdotes, subscribe to all our Dark Documentaries channels, where we publish new content regularly. Stay tuned.